It's only been a week since the big surprising gameplay reveal of Cyberpunk 2077, and CD Projekt Red has continued providing us with new information and details on this game. Let me just first add, the way that the whole social media team has been handling and discussing this game since the reveal is phenomenal, something you don't often see from a big developer like CD Projekt Red. And what I mean by that is they've been answering and communicating with fans with honest answers about certain features that we will see in Cyberpunk 2077. Today we're actually going to go through some of those replies because CD Projekt Red actually has given new details on certain gameplay features. But to start, just the other day we got new wallpapers for Cyberpunk 2077, and while this isn't really news, CD Projekt Red actually snuck in a new image of the male version of V fighting off what appears to be members of the Maelstrom gang. Interestingly, some theorized that this could be just an image from the other gameplay demo, which has the male version of V being used. As far as I understand, at E3, the female version of V was the only one being used, but at Gamescom, the male V was used. Anyway, what's strange about this image is that Jackie actually isn't at all present, which might mean that this isn't from the gameplay demo. Either way, this certainly is a very fun image, and we also get a look at what appears to be some destruction of V's vehicle. But overall, just a very cool, nice new image. Now, for those curious how companions like Jackie will work, well, a CD Projekt Red developer took to their forums and explained, like in The Witcher, if the story calls for it, you will have a companion or two for a mission. But we don't want to do a companion system where you're never alone. In some quests, you will be by yourself, and sometimes you will have one person like Jackie or even a whole group. And in other quests, you might be alone or with someone else depending on the choices you made. We really want to have it fit into the story, so basically, you'll always have someone with you if we think it'll be interesting. Essentially, this isn't going to be Fallout in which certain characters can follow you around all the time, which personally, if this helps the story, I'm all for it. Based on how The Witcher 3 handled it with occasionally having someone like Vesemir accompany you, I'm all for it being the same way in Cyberpunk 2077. Now, in my last Cyberpunk 2077 video, we went over all the new information coming from the community interview that took place on the official forums of this game. I skipped over one question, which I think a lot of people will be interested in hearing the response. Which first, the question is, where does the double jump fit in relation to a certain class? And a CD Projekt Red developer would reply with, I would suspect somewhere in the solo area. We can have strong solos if you want to make them kinda tanky with big weapons. You can also have a character that maybe you want to be more like the Major from Ghost in the Shell, basically a cyber ninja. There are skills for that as well. Moving on, next we have some of the questions people have been throwing at CD Projekt Red with some interesting responses. The first is on romance and how far this aspect of the experience will go. CD Projekt Red says, romancing is something heavily present in Cyberpunk, and the player will be able to both form meaningful connections with other characters, as well as opt for one-night stands. Next, a lot of people have been curious about how much of the world can we interact with and explore, particularly how much of the buildings will we be able to enter. CD Projekt Red's response to this question is, Night City has lots, and I mean lots of buildings, and these buildings have floors. In a tall building, we will have many of them explorable. Each floor can house a lot of activity. Continuing on, next, someone noticed that in the gameplay demo, it said V's current apartment, which made them wonder if we would be able to unlock or buy newer, better ones, and CD Projekt Red confirmed that we will be able to upgrade V's apartment. Lastly, someone would ask about how stealth works in the game, and if it would be supported. CD Projekt Red's answer is, enemies won't always be aware of the player. The player can utilize this to their advantage by sneaking up on unsuspecting enemies, laying traps, or deploying viruses. The plan of attack is just as important as executing it. We never force players to adopt any particular style of combat, so they're always free to use what they think is the best possible solution to a problem at a given time. From shooting through walls to bending bullets over corners, stealth tactics are also a part of your repertoire. Now, the last part of this video I want to go over is a recent interview Metro did with CD Projekt Red quest designer Patrick Mills. I'll say most of this interview doesn't really add much to what we haven't heard, but there are some interesting quotes given. First, Metro would ask the CD Projekt Red developer what are his priorities then for improving your work on this game, what are you looking to do differently? And his response would be, one of the things that I think is most different between this and The Witcher 3, we consider dialogue and scenes and all of that to be gameplay, because it is, right? You're making decisions, you're making choices, you're interacting with the world, but we want that to be more seamless than it was in The Witcher 3, or it is in most games. You walk into a conversation and suddenly the camera is its own camera and you're making choices. We wanted to be a little bit more fluid and a little bit more seamless. And it's a huge amount of work and it's really, really ambitious, and I hope that we're able to deliver it because it's a lot of work. And the Metro would follow up with, when you say seamless, you mean being able to walk up to people and not have to be separated by a cutscene? And then Patrick Mills would say, it's not a separate cutscene. Like in the demo, you've got those bits where you can take out your gun and change what happens in the scene. But like when you're in the Maelstrom area, for example, and you're walking away from those guys, that's all still a scene. It's all still happening as a scene. It's tightly choreographed with all those people moving around and all of that. And stuff like that is actually really difficult. Next, Metro would ask, but how much will they evolve in the game? This is actually in relation to side quests, because a lot of the time they almost seemed more interesting than the main plot, or at least more unpredictable and more focused on characterization. Is that something you're going to double down on in Cyberpunk? And then Mills would say, oh yeah, absolutely. The way that we develop side quests is very often by looking at the main story. After we've written out and sketched out the main story, we find the characters that maybe we want to spend more time with, themes, or even bits of old main story that aren't getting used anymore. Because we iterate a lot, so sometimes you wind up with something that is part of the main story, and then at some points you're like, no, main story has changed, but we'll make it a side quest. And because there's not the pressure of being part of a multi-hour long story, you have a little bit more freedom to figure it out. And for us, our rule for side quests is that the story has to be something that you've never seen before. There's got to be something in the story that's different. It's never going to feel like, go here, do that. It's you go there and you do that and then something happens. And now to the last question that we're going to go over from this Metro interview. They ask, is there an overarching theme to the game? Is there a clear goal for the character? Or are you just trying to get by? Or is there maybe a Robin Hood element where you're trying to fundamentally change the world? And Mills would respond with, what I can say is that one of the aphorisms that Mike Pondsmith has about Cyberpunk is that in Cyberpunk, you can't save the world. You can only save yourself. So I would look for something like that. This is not a game about revolution. This is a world where that is not possible. Cyberpunk 2077 is currently playable start to finish, but the release is still far away. A lot more work is needed, and they're only going to release the game when it's ready. Fortunately, CD Projekt Red has the luxury of taking their time. Personally, I'm actually surprised CD Projekt Red has been so open about Cyberpunk 2077, but it definitely is nice to see a developer being very open with their community. Anyway, I'm not sure when the next reveal will be coming, whether that may be at the Game Awards later on this year or possibly sometime in early 2019, but I really cannot wait to see more of this game. But what do you guys think of the new image and details we went over today? Let me know your thoughts in the comment section below. But thank you for watching. Make sure to leave a like if you did enjoy this video or found any informative value, and consider subscribing for much more Cyberpunk 2077 content to come, and I'll see you later.